With love letters, I offer unadulterated, heartfelt gratitude to the writers, actors, comedians, and artists of all variety who have made this world richer through the light of their brilliance. Love letters is a way for me to say thank you to these luminaries, to honor what is best in us all, and to shine a light on the people who help us rise. I offer you love letters for all these reasons, but also for the simple reason that this world is too free with critique and too stingy with compliment. And now, my eighth love letter, a letter for Haruki Murakami. Dear Haruki Murakami, thank you for Boris the Man Skinner, Deep Dark Wells Made in Another Age, Cutty Sark, Cinnamon, Nutmeg, and Zoo Animals Slaughtered, Caught in the Wrong Time and Wrong Place of the Revolving Door, as so many of us are. Thank you for Kumiko Lost and the Cat as well, for Jazz and Classical as Condiments with Perfectly Described Meals, and for a stomach as flat as paper. Thank you for spaghetti that has not been dealt a mortal blow, and for all relationships that are as standing in a vast dark room with only a cigarette lighter. Thank you for the bird that winds the world and its call that sounds just like the winding of a spring. Often, as I search for something lost, sob in a well of despair with no ladder for climbing, watch an animal running free, thrill at the thieving magpie or the magic flute, or see a bird high in a tree, I see the pages of the Windup Bird Chronicle as a gossamer shroud draped over the world, images and characters breathing, as real as my house, my family, my own arm. Thank you also for assassins with needles, reading unicorn skulls in flickering light, a plump woman in pink, inklings, and little people emerging from the mouth of a dead goat. Thank you for a man like a pig, a man like a nightmare, a lost love and two moons, a chrysalis woven with threads pulled from air, and the dowager who eats small bits of food and drinks tea like a fairy deep in the forest, sipping a life-giving dew. Thank you for loneliness and longing, despair and unknowing, and for neatly arranged ingredients for stir-fry as a vision of order before the chaos and confusion of losing. Thank you for nightmares and operas, empty boxes and shadows severed, bakeries robbed, and a forest of bent time. Thank you for Mae Kasahara, her talk of death, and her judgment of balding men with the keen eye of one who works at a wig company. Thank you for suicide notes that never turn out right, for peeling away ornament to reveal the abyss inside, and for false faces like masks with twisted things behind. Thank you for horses dying when the moon is full, for a polka dot tie missing, for thirst so bad you'd take a bullet for water, for darkness that drinks a woman down, and for sparrows constantly switching patterns like musical notes being rewritten. Thank you for butterflies that hardly seem to exist at all, and for using the abilities you have been granted with the utmost care. Thank you for possibility that sits in the palm of your hands as if you were holding a piece of paper bearing the indecipherable text of a magic spell. With immense gratitude for the worlds you create that are, like deep dark wells made in another age, secret passageways for us all. Thank you, Haruki Murakami. All my best. Sarah D. Little. Up next, Susanna Clarke.